Please be seated. Parents, family members, faculty, students, and friends, welcome to the closing exercises for the 8th grade class of 2023. Closing exercises, graduations, commencements, beginnings and endings, endings and new beginnings. A graduation ceremony can aptly be called both closing exercises and a commencement. Although it denotes the end of a particular academic career, it launches a more important beginning. In his poem, The Four Quartets, T.S. Eliot addresses this paradox concerning beginnings and endings when he writes, "The way up is the way down. The way forward is the way back. What we call the beginning is often the end, and to make an end is to make a beginning. The end is where we start from." Eighth graders, while today's ceremony celebrates the sum of your lessons learned here, your journey here at the Red Gables campus, it also marks a transition to a different stage of your ongoing journey, your endless search for truth. As you leave this campus and progress on to the high school, take solace and comfort in the knowledge that even though you will no longer be students here at Red Gables, Red Gables will always be here for you. This place is your home or home away from home. These people are your family or extended family, always. This sentiment reminds me of one of my favorite poems, Heaven, by Patrick Phillips. If you indulge me, I'd like to share it with you now. It will be the past, and we'll live there together. Not as it was to live, but as it is remembered. It will be the past, we'll all go back together. Everyone we ever loved and lost and must remember. It will be the past, and it will last forever. Eighth graders, you should feel anchored and sustained by your past, by your happy memories and lessons learned here at Red Gables as you eagerly and enthusiastically look ahead to high school and all the promise and potential of these next 4 years. You have a bright, bright future ahead of you. Godspeed, Ensworth Class of 2027. Thank you.
Good morning. Today I have the opportunity to introduce two eighth graders that truly know what it means to contribute to society. These students meet with our middle school administration to make changes that they want to see in their community. They have presented new ideas to their peers, and they have led by example all year long. They seamlessly brought back the student council to the middle school this year, and they have left big shoes for future students to fill. It's my honor today to introduce Ensworth Middle School's student body president, Christian Kurtz, and vice president, Mills Darst.
Thank you. As someone who's been here for 9 years, I'm honored to have been asked to reflect on my experience at Ensworth. For 9 years, I've had the privilege to get to grow up and mature in this nurturing environment. I can fondly look back on any of my years at Red Gables and say with certainty that each one was influential in not just supporting me as a student, but also as an individual. When we typically reflect on our time at Ensworth, most often certain traditions come to mind. Field day, pancake breakfast, the first grade pet show, the fourth grade play. While all of these are great memories, what I remember most is the important life lessons that my teachers taught us. I can remember how kindergarten taught us the importance of a positive beginning and a firm foundation, how no matter how arduous the journey ahead of you is, a good beginning is the best place to start. I can also remember how first grade impressed upon us the significance of respecting ourselves and one another, specifically through teachers like Dr. Nguyen, who showed us every day how respect is a foundational element for communication and meaningful relationships. I will not forget how second grade showed us strength and resilience. Third grade enlightened us to the value of kindness and how it can, and always should be, applied to any situation. We have teachers such as Miss May to thank for this, as she was the epitome of kindness and constantly radiated joy, making every day in class a fantastic example of this lesson. Fourth grade helped us identify our individual strengths and realize that confidence is a strong ally. Teachers like Miss Prentice taught us that knowing your strength can increase your confidence, and in turn that confidence will enhance your strengths. Fifth grade taught us integrity, specifically doing the right thing, even when no one is looking. Sixth grade taught us the importance of a strong work ethic. Mentors such as Mr. Maxwell, Ms. Figueres, and Ms. Pirelli helped us recognize that just a little perseverance, or as Mr. Maxwell called it, grit, can accomplish a great number of things. Seventh grade helped us understand the importance of applying our intelligence. Teachers like Ms. Ward, Mr. Hopkins, and Ms. Gillicorn trained us to understand that knowledge is not just something you regurgitate onto a test, but rather something to be applied to help us think more critically. Eighth grade has shown us how to live up to the high standards and responsibility that inevitably comes along with these lessons. More importantly, eighth grade has opened my eyes to the incredible value of those around me, from Mr. Wallace, to Mr. Corzine, to Ms. Henry, to Mr. Humphreys, to Ms. Roof, to Ms. Carla, and especially to the remarkable students that sit up here with me. Their support makes me better as an individual, and this class better as a whole. The students in our class represent a wide breadth of talents and gifts. Each student's gift adds a unique piece of the puzzle that makes up our class. Every day, we can see each other's bright qualities that make our grade so special. The joy of Katie Hooper, Tyler Rowe, and Aria Hanna. The humility of Tanner Tapp, Aaliyah Williams, and Tao Lee. The loyalty of Milo Miggs, Genevieve Greetens, Elsa Stalin, and Eleanor Dembo. The adaptability of Shiv Patel, Belle Lawi, Sana Mehta, and Matthew Boyce. The energy of Joe Amden, Millie Coppins, and Anders Damp. The determination of E.J. Gibson, Caroline Watts, Molly K. Orr, and Alex Applin. The curiosity of Sutton Korn, Cooper Lucy, Claire Murray, and Sarah Choma. The humor of Ben Rios, Gray Rosen, and Aiden Kilgore. The approachability of Tully Johnson, Bo Butler, Meredith McGee, and Charlotte Figler. The fearlessness of Max Barrier, Michael Hayes, and Cooper Rice. The perseverance of Henry Peck and Noah Franklin. The respectfulness of Harrison Hampton, Henry Acer, and Kiel Tierney. The passion of Elmeed Poe, Drew Bass, and Graham Dean. The confidence of Cutler Smith and Michaela Batten. The creativity of Jeremiah Easley, Lily Gorbich, and J. Wesley Looper. The gracefulness of Natalie Pete and Maddie Miller. The commitment of Zoe Rushing, Elle Hutchinson, and Hugh Mixon. The insightfulness of Soren Sagalski, Georgie Carmo, Noel Whitfield, and Emerson Darr. The sincerity of Rishi Patel, Aiden Sowell, Charlie Sewell, and Emery Turnovitz. The lively presence of Sarah Page Dale, Kate Williams, and Adeline Courtney. The spirit of Clover Martin, Giselle Michael, Macy Biller, and Ellie Weprin. The intensity of Ankeet Busalis and Delaney Flack. The vibrance of Hollis Jacobs, Logan Green, and Nariah Taylor. The dependability of Mill Stars, Mackie Kate Cowles, Mateo Scala, and Michael Ryan. The discipline of James Ross, Teddy Graff, and Caroline Cox. The honesty of Lily Goldner, Claire Fleury, Ella Blankenship, and Alana Wong. The gentle nature of Maren Carita, Evelyn Barrett, Kat Phones, and Lily Mosher. And the charismatic personalities of Tom Courtney and Dane Clark. And while these qualities and interests are especially our own, we all owe a debt to Ensworth for helping us to realize them into what they've become today. Without question, Ensworth has given us a strong academic foundation, but this school has also encouraged us to follow a number of interests, from extra academics to the arts to the athletics. Ensworth has provided us with an environment that gives a strong sense of support, regardless of someone's ability or previous experience. For instance, I felt just as comfortable in a classroom as I do singing on a stage, as I do on the defensive line on the football field. This school has permitted me to be able to pursue a variety of interests, and I'm extremely grateful for that. And thanks to this unconditional support, it also allowed me to even play basketball this year, something that is definitely not my strong suit. Thanks to being on that team, I was able to spend one more year on a basketball team and gain the invaluable guidance of Coach Hopkins, Coach Humphreys, and Coach Glotta, who showed us how to be extraordinary by putting a little extra in all the ordinary, a quote I will cite them for. Knowing that you are at a school where you're surrounded by peers and faculty who will celebrate successes with you and support you through your disappointments is an incredible blessing. It's surprising to think that 9 years have gone by so quickly, but while it feels like just yesterday this grade was walking through those doors for the first time, I know that what we've accomplished and gained here has been invaluable and has more than prepared this group for whatever might come next. Prepared us to be intellectually curious, to use our talents to the fullest, be people of integrity, and to be contributors to society. Thank you.
Wow. It's finally time for high school. With this comes a whole mix of emotions. Whether you're sad to leave Red Gables, happy to leave Red Gables, eager to begin something new, realizing our time here has gone by way too fast, not ready to move on, or more ready than ever to move on, whatever it is you may be feeling, know that our time here, or anywhere else in the lower middle school,
has well equipped you for what is to come. Hello, everyone. My name is Mills Darst, and I'm honored to be here in front of you giving this speech. It's been 9 whole years since I and 37 others beside me were new to a school campus. To others, it has not been as long, but still feels like forever. Now, it is so hard to believe that we are moving on. It is crazy to think that next year, we will not be students on the Red Gables campus. We have spent so much wonderful time here, but now it's time for change. Now, we will be little freshmen in big new buildings, but also, now, we have so much to look forward to. And while we don't want to forget about our time here, what is ahead of us is so exciting. 2 days from now, the current Ensworth seniors, including my sister Carmen, will be graduating. It seems like only yesterday I was watching her eighth grade closing exercises. But now, look where we are. As I feel hers did, the time in high school will fly by. So we need to be prepared for change and take advantage of every minute and every opportunity. While our competitive blood will always run orange or black, instead of orange or black teams, we'll have 4 tiger houses: morality, integrity, truth, and vitality. Instead of middle school dances, we'll have homecoming, winter formal, and then prom. Instead of lectures and rows of desks where you could potentially fall asleep depending on the class, we'll have lively discussions around a Harkness table. Instead of playing on the practice field at football games, we'll be up in the student section, covered in paint, screaming our hearts out. And instead of listening to our last names, followed by lane 1 or lane 2, we will eventually get spots where we can park our own cars. The high school has so much to offer, and our class is going to experience a lot of new things in the next rapid 4 years. This is what counts. As we venture there together in August, we won't have our tiger bags, or our little orange bows, our jumpers, or even khaki shorts. We will be sporting blazers, new skirts, and long pants, with no gray shirts allowed. We will sign the book in orientation, our class will expand, and there will be a lot more tigers to meet and get to know. Will we know exactly where we're going? Definitely not, but after a few weeks, what was so foreign to us will feel like home. How we decide to live our lives in high school could determine our future, so let's make the best of it. Let's take what we've learned here at Red Gables and let it multiply it for us. Let's be grateful, help each other succeed, work hard, and most importantly, have fun. Ensworth High School will provide countless opportunities for you to form into the person you aspire to be. I know and hope all of you will use it, every ounce of it, to your advantage, while helping and supporting one another along the way. Savor every moment and every chance you are given, because it could be gone before you know it. So no matter how you feel about moving along, we will all be in this together. Class of 2027, congratulations. I love you all. And most importantly, we've got this. Go Tigers.
Thank you, Mills. Thank you, Christian. I've always said that one of my favorite things about Ensworth is that our students find their voice, and there is no better way than seeing that in this moment. Y'all did an unbelievable job. I want to welcome you again this morning, faculty and staff, students, parents, families, friends, to this moment where we celebrate this really special eighth grade class. This is a group that I heard about before I even began at Ensworth. Last spring, parents and community members started to pull me aside, started talking about this group, the tightly knit bonds that you all share, the leadership qualities that they saw in you. The prevailing wisdom was that this would be a group that would redefine leadership at Red Gables, that this would be a group that when it went to the high school would set a new and even stronger foundation. And I think that is true. I think that because I saw it on the very first day of school. As you all gathered out front to greet our littlest tigers and welcome them in, while they clutched their tiger bags with white knuckle grips, you made sure that they felt at home. I want to be honest. Some of you are enormous, and you are terrifying to a kindergartner. But you got down on their level. You smiled at them, you took them by the hand, and you led. You led by the way that you welcomed. In your captain's speeches, you showed competitive fire, but all of you showed a commitment to the whole. And as you led the reborn, redesigned, remade student council, you made your mark almost immediately. You changed policies, you presented new ideas like old pros. You welcomed the mantle of leadership. You made sure that you had an impact. There were no empty titles in your group. You were about action. But it wasn't just the grand gestures with this class. It was the little things, the small moments every day. You're right, Mills. You all will no longer be on the practice field. But I watched you there this year, mobbed by your kindergarten buddies. You did not go to that game to play with them, but that is how you spent your time. In the aftermath of field day, with all of the emotions, all of the tears, all of that on the black side, I watched members of the eighth grade black team wipe their tears and wade into a sea of orange to give hugs to their classmates who had won field day for the first time since second grade. And now, at the end of the year, you find yourself in this moment of transition. You find yourself in this moment of change. The beauty of Ensworth and the two-campus model is that here at Red Gables, you as eighth graders really run this place. Your games, your recitals, your plays, those are our headline events. And that's about to change. When you drive 7 miles up the road, you'll be moving into a space where you all are the ones looking up at the upperclassmen on the first day of school. Thankfully, we do not make freshmen carry tiger bags. But you get the idea. You won't automatically be on the top. And so I want to say this to you as plainly as I can today. Lean into the leadership that has made you special as a class. Make your mark at the high school from the very start. Don't wait. The greatest error you can make as you all go to the high school, as you cross that threshold, as you sign the high school book, as you move into a space that looks and feels like a college, the greatest error is to believe that you have to bide your time. You don't. You have spent the year practicing and honing your leadership. You have already built the muscles that you need to flex to make an impact. At 120 strong next fall, this group will be over 1/4 of our high school. We need your skills. We need your energy. We need your enthusiasm. We need all your gifts and talents. A mentor of mine once said, "Confidence comes from memories of a job well done." Then you should be confident. You have done it well this year. You have led well. Don't forget it. Carry that confidence up the road. Will it be harder than it was here when people automatically looked at you to lead? Yes, absolutely, but it will be worth it. Will there be doubters both now and forever if you push yourself to make an impact before you're an upperclassman, before it's your time? Sure. Our American culture, particularly in the teenage years, has developed a bad habit of avoiding giving absolutely all of our effort for fear that we might fail and then have to face the doubters, including ourselves who told us so. It is far easier to give a token effort, and then if you fall short, blame that on not really caring or not really trying. Be bolder than that. Be braver than that. Be the class that we have watched you be all year. In 1910, as he traveled through Europe, President Theodore Roosevelt gave a speech in which he criticized those who went through life cynically, those who lived with a sneer, judging others, but refraining from being vulnerable. In a celebration of the boldness of those who dive in and work on behalf of a cause bigger than themselves, he gave what has become a famous speech. And he said this. He said, "It is not the critic who counts. Not the man who points out how the strong man stumbles or where the doer of deeds could have done them better. The credit belongs to the man who is actually in the arena, whose face is marred by dust and sweat and blood, who strives valiantly, who errs and comes up short again and again because there is no effort without error and shortcoming, but who does actually strive to do the deeds. Who knows the great enthusiasms, the great devotions, who spends himself in a worthy cause, who at the best in the end knows the triumph of high achievement, and who at the worst, if he fails, at least fails while daring greatly, so that his place shall never be with those cold and timid souls who know neither victory nor defeat. I believe that you all will set new standards for our school. And I believe that the path to the success that you will ultimately find will be littered with both highlights and moments where you fall short. Embrace that process, class of 2027. Embrace the fact that you are headed to the high school not to wait for your time, but because your time has now come. We are proud of you. Thank you for your leadership, class of 2027. We are excited to see what comes next. Congratulations.
Thank you, Mr. Stabler. Thank you, Mr. Stabler. And would you and Dr. Capone please join me on the stage as we award our eighth grade certificates. Joseph Tomas Amden. Alexander Drake Applin. Evelyn Thompson Barrett. Andrew Emerson Bass. Michaela Saray Batten. Macy Vivian Biller. Ella Eden Blankenship. Anna Keaton Busalis. Robert Matthew Boyce. Bo Collins Butler. Sarah Susila Choma. Dane Eric Clark. Millicent Wills Coppins. Adeline Armstrong Courtney. Thomas Patrick Sigenthaler Courtney. Maggie Kate Cowles. Caroline Whittington Cox. Sarah Paige Dell. Anders Boyd Damp. Emerson Lynn Dar. Millicent Ann Darst. Graham Davis Harvey Dean. Eleanor McPherson Denbo. Jeremiah Eli Easley. Charlotte Westerfeld Figler. Delaney Grace Flatt. Claire Keaton Fleury.
Catherine.
Taylor. Phones. Noah. Sebastian. Franklin. Elijah. Jermaine. Gibson. Lillian. Jade. Goldner. Lily. Aliza. Gorvich. Theodore. James. Graff. Genevieve. Rose. Greetings. Logan. James. Green. Harrison. Wade. Hampton. Aria, Macy, Lee, Hannah. Michael Webster Hayes, Jr. Catherine Whitland Hooper. Elizabeth K. Hutchison. Hollis Tamian Jacobs. Tully Thomas Johnson. Georgiana Grace Carmel. Aiden Gregory Kilgore. Sutton Hope Corn. Marin Wilson Carita. William Christian Kurtz. Isabel Beatrice Lowry. Tao Kristen Le. James Wesley Looper. Cooper Allen Lucy. Clover Mills Martin. Meredith Jane McGee. Sahana Kunal Mehta. Giselle Francis Michael. Milo Edward DiPartolo Big Mix. Madison Bertia Miller. Hugh Lathrop Mixon. Lillian Madeline Mosher. Claire Elise Murray. James Henry Asher. Molly Catherine Michaela Orr. Rishi Namish Patel. Shiv Prakash Patel. Henry Shepherd Peck. Natalie Ray Pete. Ella Mead Pohl. Cooper Holland Rice. Benjamin Alexander Rios. Edward Truett Tyler Rowe. William Gray Rosen. James Dylan Ross. Zoe Marie Rushing. Michael Edward Ryan III. Mateo Scala. Charles Malcolm Sewell. Cutler Austin Smith. Aiden Errol Sal. Mac Grace Spurrier. Elsa Jane Stalen. Soren Sagowski. Tanner Nash Tapp. Naraya Grace A.C. Taylor. Emery Catherine Turnovitz. Kale Marlon Tierney. Caroline Marie Watts. Elodie Ida Reprin. Noelle Serene Whitfield. Aaliyah Rose Williams. Caitlin Ashurst Williams. Alana Elizabeth Wong. Ladies and gentlemen, the class of 2027.
Good morning, members, class of 2027. Congratulations on all that you have accomplished to this point in your journey at Ensworth. Each of you has achieved an important milestone in your life, having demonstrated the knowledge and the skills required to take on the challenges and assume the responsibilities that lie ahead as you transition to the next phase of your growth and development. In a few short months, about 10 weeks, after what I hope is a restful and rejuvenating summer, your journey will continue on a new campus. Much of what you have come to expect here at Red Gables, dedicated professional educators who care deeply for their students, challenging academic courses that ask you to grow and stretch your minds, and numerous incredible experiences outside of the classroom that help you grow personally. All of those await you on Frist campus. In the coming years, new opportunities to discover parts of your intellect, your talents, your abilities, things about yourself that you never knew existed will present themselves, and I encourage you to take full advantage of each and every one of them. If you do, you will find yourself transformed by the experience into the very best version of you. Look around this room. Everyone, your teachers, your coaches, your advisors, and most importantly, your parents and family members. They are proud of who you are today, and they are proud of who you are becoming. They cannot wait to see what lies in store for you in the coming years, and neither can I. On behalf of the faculty and staff at Frist Campus, I am thrilled to welcome you to high school. We look forward to seeing you a few miles down the road in the fall. Your futures are bright. The high school's future is even brighter with the addition of the class of 2027. And now I invite everyone to please rise and join us in the singing of the alma mater. Thank you.
You may be seated. What an incredible year we've had together, class of 2027. As leaders of the middle school and Red Gables campus, you have shown exceptional growth. Your willingness to share thoughts and ideas have fostered an inclusive environment where everyone's voice matters. We are immensely proud of you and your achievements and express gratitude for your remarkable leadership. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. said once, "We are caught in an inescapable network of mutuality, tied in a single garment of destiny. Whatever affects one directly affects all indirectly. I can never be what I ought to be until you are what you ought to be. And you can never be what you ought to be until I am what I ought to be. This is the interrelated structure of reality." Remember this as you embark on your journey to the high school. Never forget that your connections transcend labels. You need one another to thrive and succeed. You represent the finest qualities the world has to offer, and we are truly grateful for each and every one of you. Stay focused on your path, live with authenticity, and always strive to give your best. Congratulations, and now, ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the remarkable class of 2027.
Thank you. guests. The eighth grade students will be in the quad outside. We ask you to meet them outside. And we also ask you to join us for a reception in the Patton Hall hallway. So thank you, and you are dismissed.